Hello friends, I am Prachivani, welcome you all in this video. This video will give you a very good introduction about paragraph writing and you will develop your confidence level also. Now we will go. Through this video, you will be able to compose any kind of writing material. It may be letter writing, it may be essay, it may be any kind of report or any dialogues. You will be able to compose all types of written material on the given different situations. For that purpose, you need a very good vocabulary. Just mere having vocabulary does not matter, but you will be able to formulate appropriate sentences. Hence, this paragraph writing will make you able to differentiate given types of paragraphs. So you will come to know what are the different types of paragraph, and on the basis of that you can differentiate it with a very good justification. Also, you will formulate a paragraph in words with synchronized sentence structure on the given situation or any topic. So you can select a very good sentences with a very good vocabulary and you can formulate a very impressive paragraph. Also, you can explain the theme on given paragraph precisely. After that, this paragraph writing is not only useful for you in case of writing, but also as far as speaking is concerned, you will be able to summarize any given paragraph, any given article, any given report with the correct pronunciation and intonation. So, if you are having a very good idea of paragraph writing, you will be able to summarize it. For that purpose, my reflection spot is here. Can you tell me what is paragraph? How many parts of the paragraphs have? And what are the different types of paragraphs? I hope up to your schooling, you might have understood well concept of paragraph. Also, you might have good idea about many parts of the paragraph and different types of paragraphs you might have written. So we will see all the details related to that. So what is paragraph? Paragraph is a group of sentences organized around a central topic. So generally, paragraphs are written over the given topic and related to that different sentences have been given. Paragraph comprised of ideas leading to topic. So here you can see the sample paragraph given for the purpose. For that purpose, I have used here highlighted colors. So also the very first word that is shown to you, that is a smartphone, indicates this is the topic of this paragraph. The green color given to the sentence indicates this is a topic sentence, and last one is your concluding sentence or concluding idea. In the meanwhile, we have used here pink color for the text. It indicates all are the supporting details. Now we will see. A smartphone is a mobile phone that can do more than other phones. They work as a computer. Are mobile devices small enough to fit in a user's hand? The users include sending and receiving emails, text, photos, and multimedia messages, registering contacts, calculator, currency, alarm, browsing internet, and much more. The smartphone comes with a touchable display and inbuilt QWERTY keyboard. These are small computers. Most can do multitasking. It is a much easier and quicker. Hence, smartphones have become the choice of more people. So, when we are going to observe this complete sample paragraph, you will come to know that the first given sentence is called your topic sentence, because topic sentence is related to the topic and it gives us clear-cut idea what is coming to the next. All the sentences given into the pink color tells us that sentences are associated with the topic sentence. So we can easily understood that these are the supporting details provided for this. Also, the concluding sentence can give you message that now the paragraph is coming to an end. So here you can easily see that is concluding idea is given and it is marked with the concluding remark. That is, hence it shows here the paragraph communication is going to be ended. Hence, smartphones have become the choice of more people. Generally, it is given that topic sentence must match with the concluding idea and it should be the same one. And at the end, it should be the convincing one. Now, we will go for the next, this image will give you or it will memorize you your schooling days. Even at a school, you might have well understood paragraph writing is a process of just like a hamburger. In hamburger, you can here observe how the hamburger is prepared. Like that, we have to prepare our paragraph also. So the first piece of this burger and last piece of burger gives us complete idea. That first is called your topic sentence and last one is your concluding sentence. In the meanwhile, you can find out the different layers so that it will add test into this hamburger. Like that, in case of paragraph writing, if you are going to support your topic sentence along with supporting sentences 1, supporting sentence 2, supporting sentence 3 and many more, so that it will add a true essence in that topic. Also, the concluding sentence refers to the topic sentence. We are going to repeat it and it will sum up the main idea of the paragraph. Now, I would like to discuss with you elements of paragraph. To make your paragraph catchy, impress you, you have to follow certain elements. So, we will see. First is unity, means the unified around the main topic. Means all the sentences must be well unified around the main topic. There should not be any kind of track off of any sentence, any irrelevant sentence we cannot add in this paragraph. Also have an order. So logical sequencing of ideas must be there inside the paragraph. So paragraph must be a very good organization of supporting sentences. Also it should have coherence, means all the ideas must be interconnected with the sentences but have a little bit transition. So with a little bit changes. Avoid monotonous sentences, monotonous phrases that we are using in the paragraph. Also have a sense of completeness. Once you start writing a paragraph, at the end you have to give that kind of sentences that gives a very good sense of completion. So concluding sentence must reinforce the topic sentence and gives idea that your communication is going to be ended. So we will see different types of paragraph. There are total 4 types of paragraph that we have to learn. The first one is your technical paragraph. I hope that up to schooling you might not have got this particular concept. So technical paragraph is completely different from descriptive or narrative type of paragraph because it is a completely technical one, informative type of paragraph. Just information related to any technical device you have to add. Also, the language is here clear as well as straightforward. Even the language is direct language, having no any twistness in the sentences. So it is a well-structured paragraph. And very important is here, there is no addition of personal opinion. So this image will show you, if you want to write down paragraph on vacuum cleaner or any kind of blower, computer blower, then you have to develop this technical paragraph with the help of given all that features. Second type of paragraph is your descriptive type of paragraph. As you know, descriptive paragraph requires your description of any event or any incident. So this description must be appealing to all our 5 senses. Means when we are going to prepare any paragraph on the basis of any kind of description, then it should be appealing to our all senses. It should keep our all senses alert. It should be pleasing one. Also, the writer can use your figurative language so that the paragraph can be well understood and well realized by the reader. So if I have to write down paragraph on sunset or sunrise, the language I have to select accordingly. Here I cannot be always informative, my language cannot be straightforward. I can use your figures of speech, I can use your different metaphors, similes to describe the event or any kind of incident. So that is the differences between technical paragraph and descriptive paragraph. The third type of paragraph is your narrative paragraph. Narrative paragraph itself gives us idea that we have to go for narration. We have to narrate a story or tells a story. Even then, in story, if we are not going to follow the sequence of any event, it will become here less understandable or it will become here less monotonous. So for narrative type of paragraph, you have to mind to have a sequence of events, have a sequence of proper action. So your paragraph should have proper beginning, middle as well as ending one. You cannot go for switching. You cannot tell middle. You cannot tell the climax of your story, or you cannot end up your paragraph with the beginning style or any kind of middle descriptions. So you have to follow this kind of the norms. Also, in narrative paragraph, it is essential to put forth the characters, plot, or events that you are going to communicate. Also, what kind of conflict or climax you might have. So all these things should be well narrated, but have a proper beginning, middle, and ending. At the end of narrative paragraph, certain morals should be provided. So in this way, narrative paragraph will be written accordingly. So for narrative type of paragraph, you can see here how a lady is spending her 1 hour on a railway station. It can be given here. So it can be narrative type of paragraph. The last one is your compare and contrast type of paragraph. In this paragraph, you might have a very good idea that in comparing, we have to compare the similarities. You have to focus on similarities, similar points. And in case of contrast, you have to focus on differences. Also, while writing comparison as well as contrast on the given any titles, you have to follow certain phrases to avoid the monotonous tone of your paragraph. In case of comparison, you can use your phrases such as similar to, similarly, in the same way, like, equally, again, also, to, each of, just as, and so on. For showing how the given title is different from the another one, so you can change your sentence by using the different phrases like in contrast, on the other hand, different from, whereas, while, unlike, such kind of conjunctions or phrases you can use while developing your paragraph. For example, you have to write down paragraph of having compare and contrast on differentiate how animals are different from the plants. So in this case, you can use such type of vocabulary, such type of phrases, or any kind of adverbs, any kind of conjunctions to indicate how you are going to differentiate the lifestyle of both of them or differences between both of them. So I hope you might have understood the different types of paragraphs and features of paragraph, what is expected out of this paragraph writing. Definitely you can follow all that features in your writing. So thank you very much.